Hey guys, what's going on? My name is Nate. I am the co-founder of Apipheny.io. I'm also the co-founder of mogulmetrics.com. And today I'm actually going to be showing you guys how to do a post request in Google Sheets using the Apipheny.io Google Sheets add-on. Now, what is a post request? Well, a post request allows you to take data that's in a Google Sheet and allows you to pass that information into that API of that software. And a post request is used all across the internet. So if you are, maybe filling out a form on a website, you give them your first and last name, you give them your email address, maybe you give them your actual mailing address. And as soon as you press that submit button, that is actually creating a post request on the back end and sending that information to a CRM like HubSpot or Salesforce that they may have. So a post request is used all over the internet. Whether maybe you're signing in to Facebook and you're putting in your email and password, that is sending a post request to their server, letting the server know that, hey, this person has credentials, let them log into Facebook. So with that being said, let's go ahead and do a post request. I'm using the examples I have ready for you guys. So the first thing you're going to do is you're going to download the Apipheny API tool from the G Suite Marketplace. And I'll have a link in the description below so you can go directly to the G Suite Marketplace and download it. Once you download it and install it, all you have to do is go to add-ons. And then you may have to refresh. All you have to do is go to add-ons and then click on Apipheny API tool, click import API, and the user interface will show up on the right-hand side. Since I already installed it and have it up, let's go ahead and do our post request. So right now it defaults to a GET request, but what we're actually going to do is do a post request like we're doing in this demo. And I actually have an example from requestbin.com, and I'll be able to take this URL, and this is will allow me to do a post example. And I go back to the spreadsheet. I put in the URL path, which is the request bin sample post slash JSON. So all I have to do is go down here to the post body, and we go to the post body here, and we paste that in. And I can make this larger by dragging this down. And once we have the post body ready to go, let's just go ahead and click run. And we have a success. So we're good there. So that's the first test. The second test is going to be a little bit simpler. So I'm going to copy this URL over to our Google Sheet. And let's actually run it in Sheet 3. So I'll go back here. And this time it looks like it's an echo post. Let's go ahead and copy this over. There we go. All right, so let's do this test. So let's click run. And we have another success. Yeah, so we're good there. So if you wanted to save this, all you have to do is click save, and you can name it post example. And then we click save, and then it is now saved. But if you go to your manage save request, you'll be able to see that post example, and you can either run it there manually, or you can go into the third tab, which is schedule, and you can create a scheduled request, and let's name it post request scheduled. And we can take the post example and have it run every hour, every day, every week, every month. So if you do want to pass along information on a regular basis to a software platform that has an API connection, you can do it on whatever cadence you like. And that's it as far as the features of the Apipheny.io tool. That's it as far as doing a post request. If you guys have any questions, feel free to reach out to us on Apipheny.io. That's it as far as doing a post request demo. I'm Nate. from epiphany.io signing off, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Later, guys.